Hello guys, how you doing? Right, we're going to play Rising Storm 2. I'm going to do something a little bit different with it as well. Basically, there is helicopter training modes in Rising Storm 2. And if you know what the helicopter combat is like in this, and if you've seen the performance of some people, it's really, really shocking. So I thought I could try and give it a go myself and just have a go at flying helicopters in an actual battlefield. So I'm going to do a little bit of the training mode, and then we'll jump into one of those helicopter-only servers and try it out in an actual battle. Yeah, why not? I've seen so many people crash into trees and rocks and stuff trying to fly those helicopters. I'm just thinking, how hard can it actually be? Granted, I have had a little go on it, but I've kind of forgot all the controls. So I'm going to have a little go, and then we'll transfer those skills over to an actual battle and see if we're any good. Right, 2 seconds. Actually, you know what? Noises. Just have the music on. It's going to take a while to load. Boom, 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 boom. I'm just flicking through Twitter. Flick through Twitter while it loads. It takes a while to load this. I don't know why. It's very, like, buggy and weird when you load it. So you just cannot touch anything while it loads. Noises. See, I can't skip through all the logos as well because it's still loading. Are you done? Are you done? Right. Fantastic. There we go.
Whoop.
Right. So, you have like a boot camp mode. And you've got the practice mode. You can do the shooting range, or you can do the helicopter range. I barely touched the helicopter range. But I tried it on the weekend, and I had a little bit of a fly around. Nothing too drastic. But it was quite fun. So we'll see if I remember anything. Basically, you've got the thing with the helicopters, like, you use all of them. Like, if it's that resort map, you've got to use the transport helicopters. There's also some attack ones in there as well. But it's mostly like the Hueys, and you just fly them straight in there. So you've got to kind of learn how to fly quite low to the ground, so you avoid getting shot, basically. Right, what we got? I'd like a revolver, please. Revolver. Right, cool. Join that one. Right. So these are the Hueys. There's two variants of the Hueys. You have the normal transport Huey, with just the M60 on the side. Or you can have the one with the two M60s on the side, and miniguns, and I think, yeah, rockets as well. This one is more of your battle Huey. It's still just the same sort of transport. A bit less so because it has just like ammo in the back rather than seats, whereas this one can transport more people. But we'll try this one because the fly pretty much is exactly the same. But this one just has weapons, so it's better. If I could get in, that'd be great. I've spawned to the wrong one, haven't I? I need to be combat pilot. Is that better? Yeah. Alright, so the helicopters in this, I figured out, it was the fact that you have to build up the RPM, as you can see in the bottom left. Oh, let's turn on advanced flight model as well. Yes, there we go. Apparently that gives you a bit more control over what the helicopter does. We'll see. And then it's space to gain altitude. And it's kind of roughly like Battlefield controls in a way. More sensitive, but I think the reason I crashed them before was because I had the controls inverted. So I'll jump into a match, start flying the helicopter, and let's go face first because I think pulling back is going to point you down, and pulling up is going to point you up. I had the controls inverted, so it was the other way around. This thing has a lot of cool weaponry. That is devastating when you're on the ground. How do I swap over? I can't leave the helicopter. It's not Battlefield where you accidentally fly out of it. Let's zoom in. Q, 1, 2, 3. What tab is that? Controlling his altitude. That's auto hover, so if we start spinning around like a maniac, press G, and that puts on auto hover. Where's the rockets? Not say to public. You think it'd be on the left hand side? I have no idea. What's that? Is to control the helicopter. Alt? No. Said. No. I don't know. It's very odd. So there is miniguns. Maybe the co-pilot uses it. I'm not too sure. Okay, let's try and get a bit further down. Once I started having a go on it, I haven't done the advanced flight model yet, but I see what it does. Gives you greater control over the altitude. It's my years of playing armor coming into fruition. Oh, fucking hell, it was a bit hard. But yeah, that's all right. Of armor, it's a little bit more realistic in the sense that it is just a lot more procedure. This is a bit, well, in terms like comparison to armor, this is not as bad. It's just build the RPM and then just fly. Once you've got the movement, okay, it's not too bad. Some of the other helicopters. Now, I know there's the Little Bird helicopters, the MHs, which are nice and easy to fly. I do like flying those. You can do like smaller landings than that. right in the middle. Could be worse. Not too bad. Okay, let's try this thing. So this only has miniguns, but I think the video says that you can use this as like a mobile command platform. I suppose you could actually have the commander in the back and then you can just call in airstrikes. So as you would guess, this is a lot lighter, a lot more nimble, but a lot more responsive. Try and fly this a bit lower to the ground. I used to do this in armor. Really shit people up. Is it gonna crash? Is it gonna crash? No, because I'm a professional. He says. I'm not that good. My Predator's achievement is playing Daisy and flying the Osprey VTOL aircraft. Fucking up, that thing is just like a sky whale. That's all that thing is. It is just horrible to fly. But I flew it. I did it. I flew it for everyone. Just getting used to the altitude meter. When it goes below halfway, it starts going steadily down. That's the one thing I'm not used to. I'm used to having just like hard up and hard down, you know. There's no like meter that tells you how far you can go. Because in armor, it's just like straight up or straight down. So there's no giveaway. This is actually quite nice. Because you can say how much you want to go down by. I'm just going around this river. It's quite nice if you want to go a bit lower. I say go lower. Even though this is still going down, it's going down at a gradual rate, so you can determine which one you want. That's quite nice. I wish armor had that. Because armor is just like you press Z to go down and something else to go up. Sorry, shift to go up, I think. And it is just like straight up or straight down. There's no leeway. It's a bit more rigid. But this is nice and free flowing. Emergency stop. Not bad. I'll be happy with that if I did that. This is what you got to do though. Like I learned how to fly stuff in armor by playing armor. Just playing Daisy, finding the helicopters. And once you play Daisy and you've got one of those modded servers that have helicopters, you protect it with your life because they're so rare that you just use them sparingly, and when you do use them, you use them properly or else. The Osprey that I was on about, the MV-22, fucking I crashed it. It's one of my greatest memories is me crashing the thing because I accidentally jumped out because of armor's weird control system. Yes, just me screaming down the mic, jump the fuck out. As it was just barreling towards the ground, on fire somehow. I don't know how it catched on fire, but it was a good day. No, it wasn't a good day. It was horrible. I got reprimanded for about 2 weeks because of crashing it. But I was the only one who could fly it, so you know, swings and roundabouts. But ever since then, I've always kind of leaned towards the helicopters in games. Planes, I can fly the planes in armor, but not as good as helicopters, I don't think. Planes are going to have like a bit of pre-planning. Like with this, I can just go whoop and just land on there. But with planes, you kind of have to think about what the fuck you're doing, and I just missed that completely. Try that again, shall I? Yeah, with planes you have to think about where you're going and where your flight path is and how to land. Landing is just like an ordeal. I can do it, but I still prefer helicopters. More maneuverable. Now, doing a landing like this would just mean you get shot. So I gotta do those really quick landings. Pico? Do this one, I can just go whoop, landing spot. Don't think the trees matter too much on this. They're not gonna fuck you up. Whereas in armor, so it's like one branch and you go flying. That's why I think I never really got right. It's one of the miniguns. And yeah. Again, it's just planning where you're going, like an aeroplane, but with helicopters, you can kind of hover there, but I'm thinking, like, if you start hovering in this and just stop in midair, you will just get shot within 5 seconds, because somebody will be watching you. If I did this, like, slow to a halt, even worse, put fucking auto hover on, slow down a little bit and just went, yes, it looks cool, but you'd probably get shot straight away. There's no rockets on this, I don't think. New rockets. Like the video said, that you could use this as a mobile command platform, so you can have the commander in the back, just plotting out different things on the map, which is a great idea, but at this height you would get shot at, so would you want to do that? I think it's better if the commander is on the ground. At least you can hide a little bit. I mean, that's as high as it can go on this map. So somebody would be shooting you at this height. All the time. Not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, let's fly back to base. We'll try the Cobra. So the Cobra is the attack helicopter, so this is the one with all the fucking missiles and the miniguns and the cannons. Really, really nice to use. But you got to use it sparingly. Especially the missiles. The missiles, if you've only got like 20 missiles. Yes, they rain death from above, but I think it's recommended you use the cannons all the time because it is like explosive ammo. It's not too bad. I like how there's a co-pilot that just magically spawns in. Fuck you. Oh god. Yeah, this is actually really nice. I like these helicopters. Big, dumb, stupid aerial tanks. That's what they are. Now this, you wouldn't be landing because it has no passenger sides. There's nothing on it, basically. It is strictly just for attacking and landing back where you came from. If there even is a base that you can land back on. But the main part of the trick behind this is The cannon. Doesn't look like much, but doesn't look like much. But if he was on the ground, yeah, you wouldn't want to be shot by it. Let's put it that way. Not as fast as the other little bird, but it packs a punch. Yes. Of course, it's got tracers on it, so your team know where you're firing, which is nice. And then you've got the other rockets, which is left mouse click. 21 rockets. That's what two of them do. That's what 10 of them do. They are devastating when you're on the ground. But you're only meant to be using them sparingly. You're meant to be using the main cannon. Hence why it's called the main cannon. Which is a bit strange. You'd think it would be like swapped over. Like left click would be the cannon, then middle mouse would be the rockets. But no, you can't. You can go for those rockets like really fast. Of course, you can go back to base and resupply, but in the heat of battle, you can't really do that sometimes. I'll try zooming in sometimes. Doing these turns, you use Q or E to like turn the helicopter, and just combine that with a turn, as in a normal helicopter turn. You can kind of do like a drift. Oh no! Ah! I wasn't paying attention. I was too busy drifting. Whoops. It'll respawn in a bit. Should we do the transport helicopter just to make sure that we know how to use it? Do we need to be the other one? Yes, we do. Okay. I know it's exactly the same as the Huey, but I'm just going to try landing this one, see if there is any differences. I'll be a bit more nimble. I don't know. Less armaments on it. Trying to land it here. I mean, if everybody did that on resort, then we wouldn't have a problem, would we? It's not too difficult. I know it's kind of me saying that because I'm a bit biased, but for me, it's not too bad. Yes, it's a bit of a different story when people are shooting at you, but hopefully you get there in time before they do start shooting. Let's try that one more time. There's no real difference to this one. It is just kind of the same as the attack version. So we're attacking this objective, we'll get down. Altitude, go to a steady stop, balance it out, land, drop off the troops, then get off, and go back up. Easy. I remember some stories of DayZ where I had to land in such awkward positions. Like, we had a base north of the entire map, there's like this little dam where we set up a base, and I had to land the Osprey within like a makeshift.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science.
Hello, new. Yeah, I had to land this Osprey within a makeshift helipad, which was interesting. But I managed to do it. The thing with the Osprey, it has fucking wheels. I hate landing with wheels. Give me rails, don't you, though? Fucking wheels. Just roll around. Who wants that? Vietnam Radio? You right now? Land. It's going to be a bit shallower than that. A little bit of altitude. Go back down. Land. Drop off. Back up. And away we go. I can do this with people shooting at me. Try that a few more times. You see, I did look at the trailer. It's alright. I mean, I'm not really a steampunk fan. I never really liked the aesthetic. Except for like one game, Guns of Icarus. I fucking love that game. But apart from that, I've never really been a fan of steampunk. But as a survival game, looks interesting. It literally just came out yesterday, didn't it? Or the day before. To the 29th it got released. So, I know it's me being a bit contradictory, but I'm trying to go away from early access survival games, even though we played Subnautica last night. Stuff that I don't, like, initially know about. There's more than enough survival games to play, and I do have some others in my head. Like, I want to play The Forest. Like, I know it's a horror game, but I still want to play The Forest. Because of the same vein of, like, Subnautica stuff. But, it looks alright. Looks alright. It's just early access. Looks like early days, yeah. You like to, but yeah, it's not my preferred theme. I've never really liked it, except for Guns of Icarus, which I fucking loved. More people should play Guns of Icarus. I saw Fuman playing it, I want to try it to the front. Yeah, yeah, I've been flicking around on it. I was meant to get it on sale, but I forgot I spent too much on the sale, so I decided against it. But fucking hell, I've got too many games to play anyway. Far too much to play. Multiplayer, yeah. I think it has multiplayer as well, and yeah, it just looks fun. It's like a laugh. Wouldn't know what I'm doing on it, but yeah, it does look fun. Even though it's a horror game, and I have a strict policy on horror games where I don't play them, because it's a horror survival game. I don't really mind, because I've played Terraria. Terraria? Yes, Sam. Terraria. The well-known horror game, Terraria. Subnautica. It's, yeah. I think it's sort of the same sort of caliber of game. Ooh. Fuck that one up, didn't I? What happened? Oh, shit. I knocked the skid off. Your fault! Your fault! Whoops. And it's my wish list when I'm done with a few games. Plan on buying it if there's no other games to. Yeah. Fair enough, yeah. I mean, I've just got so many games in the backlog right now. I know I'm playing this like for the millionth time, but there's so many games that I've just got on the backlog where it's just I need to get around to streaming them, and a lot of them need just testing on stream before I start streaming it. Just takes time. I want a nice quality when I'm streaming. You know, when we were playing Worms the other night and it just fucked up. That's because of me not testing it. I want to try and avoid that whenever possible. Oh, I'm in the wrong seat. You want to play Stardew? I never liked Stardew as well. Well, I like the art style and it did engross me for a little while, but there's not much to it. It's like it just reminds me of Farmville. Or like those kind of games never really caught on with me. Again, there's nothing wrong with the game, it's just not for me. It was cheap enough for me to buy it, and I got a bit bored of the whole, you know, just farming stuff, just waiting for crops to grow. I mean, it is just waiting for plants to grow. And then you sell them off, get more stuff, and then it's just... Ugh. The reason I'm giving it is an amazing story. I would say amazing, it's just, you inherit a farm and you run the farm. That's about it. There's more to it, I suppose, if we talk to the characters. But I was just like, I don't know, maybe with the art style mixed in with the whole you have to just talk to people and wait around. I don't know. I just found it really boring. It just reminds me of Farmville. There's like hidden creatures and monsters. There probably is, but I just wouldn't get that far. And the world traversal is just like, yeah. I just fell asleep. Like, it's just not my thing. I just fell asleep a little bit. Whereas something like, I know it's like the complete opposite, but RimWorld has farming, I suppose. But it always has blood and torture, and you know something interesting happens. I need a little bit of drama in my games, I think, sometimes because. These happy-dappy games are just boring for me. I just need to shoot something or kill something. I mean, it describes me as a person, really, doesn't it? Just I need to have a gun at all times. but it's... So, let's start it. It's not a bad game by any stretch. But it's a little bit boring for me. Not much to do. Fuck you, house. Feel like Graveyard Keeper. What's that? I've heard of it. I haven't seen any of it. Anything about it? Fuck that up. Whoa! Whee! 360 fire support. Woo! I'm gonna try and land this. Yeah, no worries, no. Oh, fuck. I fixed it. Oh, no, I haven't. Because if you gain altitude, it starts, spinning. Okay. I land it. Ooh. Ooh. What happened? Oh, I kind of got cut off. It's in the gunner seat, but nobody flies it. Whee! Oh, let me just have another quick spin in the little birds, and we'll try a match. I just want to get familiar with it. I used to do this in DayZ as well. Like I used to jump on normal armor, fly around in the helicopter for a bit, and then get myself warmed up to fly the helicopters in DayZ because it was that precious. I was hooked at flying helicopters. and being the only one in your group who can fucking fly them, who can be bothered to learn the controls. It became my responsibility. Annoyingly. It's really annoying as well, when somebody phones a helicopter, I was the only one who could fly them, so I had to stop what I was doing, go over to them, which was probably like halfway across the map, then get into the helicopter, then fix the helicopter, then transport my car that I got there in the first place underneath the helicopter and bring them both back to the base. To me, hours. Because nobody would learn the fucking controls. Underneath the bridge. So try it. We did it. Try doing that in the Cobra. Oh, I had the thing on. Ooh, gonna make it. Oh, no. Let me try that again. Nailed it. Thanks, Juan.
Gentlemen?
You're right. How you doing? Let me do that again. I can nail that. I can do it. I did it in an Osprey in armor. I can do it in this. I flew under bridges when nobody was looking. You wanna go up, maybe? Yeah, you take your time. I keep accidentally spotting things with Z. It's nothing to do with Z, it's control, it's left control to go up and down. I think I want to go down. I'm going, there's an enemy! Ah. There's no one there. No one there. I can do that again. I can do this. Where is it again? Oh, for fuck's sake, I keep getting the control. I thought control was up and space was down. Not my fault. Alright, I'm going to do it. In fact, to redeem myself properly, I'm going to do it in the Cobra. The bigger one. Okay? If I do it in the Cobra, then those two mistakes are nil. Right, we're on even ground then. Born to fly. It's falling with style. Okay, if I can do it in this, then those two are just nothing. This is bigger and worse to fly. Here we go. I'm doing it. Got in a trap. Right, altitude down. Okay, technically, I went under it. I said nothing about going out on the other side. I can do this now. One more in the little bird. They will play a natural match. I doubt in an actual match we'll have to do this, but it's, you know, it's a skill. We can say that we can do it. We got in a trip. Thank fuck, there's no power lines. Imagine if there was like power lines, like in armor. Armor has power lines, and if you fly into them, you just crash and die. Thank fuck there's none in Vietnam. Suspicious minds, yeah, stuck in my head.
We're caught in a trap.
Yeah, boy! I'm back the other way. Woo! I'm at the wrong altitude. Oh, fucked it up. Ah, oh. I did it! I did it though. Oh god, this is a bit realistic now, isn't it? Blood on the windscreen. I'm gonna land here, I need a new co-pilot. Mine had an accident. He didn't make it under the bridge. Can I have a new one? Get in a trip. What happens if you go like full altitude without the RPM? Oh, he doesn't do anything. For some reason in my head I thought you'd like flip over. It's nice though, I do like the altitude thing, even though I keep getting mixed up what key it is. I like how you can just change what altitude you're at and do it like gradually. You can do it like really fast. That's really good. It's a nice change. We're going on a trip. Still playing Space Engineers, Swan? You made the geep. Yeah, I think I'm pretty happy with this. Whoa. I think I got a new one. Alright, I'm happy with that. Let's see if there's any helicopter maps. There might not be. Where's that one where it's just like helicopter maps only? It's not there, is it? Ah, it's that one. Two people playing it. There's usually more than that. We'll check back later. Is there any of those that doing helicopters? 937 has helicopters. Go on then. We'll just try it. We'll try it on a low pop server and see what happens. If we can get one. They're working on the moon shuttle to get off my planet. Wow. Okay. Getting a bit bored of your planet, are you? Good luck. Welcome back, New. Combat pilot. There we go. Oh my god. Right, I'm going to fly the little birds. I'm actually kind of nervous. This is an actual war now. I'm scared.
We are taking Charlie.
Space engineers now. I'm playing just fine. It has no platinum. Gotta go to space. 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 I want space. Space. Gotta go to space.
Space!
Oh, fucking hell. Alright, this is nerve-wracking.
Hey, Cargo Bravo 2-6. I need recon on the area.
RPG launch.
You able to help out? Bravo 2-6 over.
Bravo 2-6 to Murdoch. Roger, I can do that for you. We'll be overhead in just a few.
Spot resist. I spotted people. I'm trying to do strafing runs. I'm actually sweating. This is weird. Why am I so nervous about this? Whoa, fucking Jesus Christ. Take cover. Oh, fucking hell. Now you don't like me anymore, doo-da. I actually got someone! Yes! My first helicopter kill. Yes! If you're not percent ammo, we're doing well. C's been taken, so let's just keep hammering D.
We have taken Charlie.
Whoa! I love if he says RPG, like.
Status check shows we're all good.
Fucking hell.
Charlie is being attacked.
Ooh, I've got the angle wrong there. Hang on. Fucking hell. Those RPGs are not nice.
Everything checks out. We're in good shape.
Wrong again. It's difficult getting this angle right. I'm in training mode now.
We have lost Charlie. We are taking Delta.
Woohoo! Okay.
We're in good shape. Bravo 2-6 and Bird Dog. Roger, I can do that for you. We'll be overhead in just a few.
Very close to those RPGs.
Recon is in the air.
Does it can program certain parts using C sharp? Wow. So you can do that actual scripting, this one. Cool.
Bird is nearly dry on ammo.
We have taken Delta.
We're taking fire.
Oh, fuck, there's a Dushka there. I've got another one. Right, I'm going to go back to base, get some more ammo. Have I got the commander in me? I think I've actually got the commander on me. So, I'll do one more run.
Take cover.
What was that, damn it?
Ah, fuck it. Oh no, I've gone to the... Wait, I got shot and then spawned in as the co-pilot. Okay. Whoa, okay, land this. Taken off, hasn't he? Yeah.
Copy. Picked up. Reloading. Rearming confirmed.
Let's try this again, shall we? Right, there's a Dushkron C, so we've got to be careful of that. Trying to get shot again.
We are taking Charlie.
They're taking C. Hopefully they took out the emplacement. Yeah, the commander's on the back of me. That's cool.
Bravo 2-6, bird dog. Roger, I can do that for you. We'll be overhead in just a few. See what you see for you.
Notice they don't have the landings. It's
Recon is in the air.
Quite simple, actually. Because you see that little meter there going up and down, that's the altitude. That's me controlling it with space and left control.
Delta is being attacked.
It's a little bit nicer because I've learnt how to fly helicopters in games. Pretty much through Battlefield and Armor. So all their control schemes kind of merge together. This is a little bit different because we've got the advanced flight model on. And what that means is that you have more precise control over the altitude meter. So in a basic mode, it is just like fully auto, like going all the way up or fully down, like all the way down. You don't have a choice whether it's like going in the middle or if it's, you know, just if it's just like slightly up or slightly down. It's you got more choice, which is quite nice, and you don't have that in armor. Motherfucker. Holy crap. Get in a trap. Let's see if we can get up. No. Oh, fine, I'll be the gunner. Fine. I'm ready. Where the fuck are we going?
All systems show green across the board. Nice.
How do I control this? Give me control. I mean, I know I was bad, but... Come on now. Come on now. This right, they're gonna cap it, but whatever. I'm amazed I even got any kills. That's like really impressive. They're all in one area now, so they're going to have focused fire on the helicopters. Go up. Up, 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 up. That was a bit naughty. I unloaded all the rockets on them. It doesn't turn as nice. I don't know how to activate flares. Oh, fucking hell.
We're in good shape.
Go up, 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 up.
Right.
This is harder than it looks, okay? These things are not as nimble as the little bird. Doing too badly. Woo! I'll say that.
Enemies there.
In there. Very interesting. He was shitting me. He almost did that.
Rearm and repair.
Yeah, let's try that again. It's like approaching from like the back of their spawn is probably best. Inbound. Take cover. There's a lot of missiles. No kills though. Gotta watch out using the tilt keys, because I think it slows down the helicopter really badly, especially in the Cobra. You don't really feel it in the little bird. Oh, cheeky bastard. Hello, Unsung. Good to go and work. Just dropping by to go doodle. No worries, man. Have a good day at work. See you in a bit.
Recon is in the air.
You must be the gunner.
Sorry.
I'm happy with that. You can be the gunner if you want to be the gunner. 5 minutes left. Oh my god.
Shot a friendly.
Whoops.
Fire, check for damage.
Happens to anyone. There's blood everywhere.
Final objective. Napalm inbound. Take cover.
I've got napalm. Oh, that was close. They're attacking in there. We've got to be careful not to shoot our own troops. Shift the focus onto our guys on the ground, not us, hopefully. Loads of them. Yes. I'm getting the hang of it now. Oh, fucking hell. It's so easy to shoot your own team, though. I'm sorry. Fucking hell. Alright, one more run. We'll go back to base, get some more stuff. So, there's 2 minutes left, though. Engine damage, we're going down. That's it. Got no control. I've just got to serve my team kill penalties. It is really hard not to team kill.
Soldier,
you going in that? All right.
Status check shows we're all good.
There's a minute left.
AC-47 inbound. Take cover.
I wanna go. You wait for the RPM to go into the green, and then it takes off. If you do it a bit too soon, it takes a while to pick off the ground. We're okay, though. How long have we got left? 30 seconds. We've got, like, one strafing run in us. These are fun, though. I like these.
Base, we're in good shape.
You can dodge the rockets in this a bit better. Yeah, but we lost. Lost!
Fall back. We've lost this time.
That reminds me, I have a backlog of red versus blue to binge on. I know, I'm on mine too. God, that's going back a bit, isn't it? How long have they been going on? Red v blue. Be going on for freaking ages. I remember them back in the old Machinima days. Oh, season 13. Jesus. I mean, they were some of the first Machinimas to ever be made, weren't they?
Đây là mảnh đất của chúng ta.
Alright, no helicopters on this side, I'm afraid. Straight up combat. Go through the... Here they come. Maybe. Yeah, the start. Yeah, I just remember them from like the old actual machine channels. It's like some of the first things they ever put out. Crap. Okay then.
Elfi's in being
attacked. 22, 24. There's the helicopter. Oh fuck, I saw him as well. On the helicopter back.
Scout, report in.
Shit. What the fuck? Okay, I shot at least 10 rounds at him. And he didn't die? Excuse me, what the fuck? I imagine it just formed like a lovely little circle around his body.
Rajin Bout, take cover.
Oh, fucker. Hey, it's me. What? I don't like Vietnam. I want my helicopter. I want my helicopter. We have no commander. We actually haven't got a commander.
Bravo is being attacked.
That's napalm.
Tôi sẽ cho bọn Mỹ thấy chúng ta đang đối mặt với ai.
Let's put this on a door. And when the sneaky Americans come, they won't know what hit them.
Delta is being attacked.
Well, let me put one here. I could put one there. They'll never know. Sneaky Joe. In a trip. What was that? What was what? What? Weird. Of course. What are you burying the sands? A cake. Filled with knives. It's a trap. Any Vietnamese class can have a Punjab trap. Is it Punjab? Punji? Or something like that? I can't remember. It's a trap they put in the sand and then you can just bury it. There's mortality. Yeah. That was the cruelness of life. But everyone has these... Punji. Punji trap. There you go. Punji traps. And you can put them in the ground. I think the Grenadier has the tripwire mine, which is even better. But you didn't hear that from me. You can really fuck them up with a tripwire. Hello, Knight. How you doing?
Hello?
Hello? Oh, fuck us. You want a 30-second delay? Ah, oh, no. Never mind. It's alright. Good, love this stuff.
Delta is being attacked.
I hope we win this, so I can plan the helicopters again. I want to fly one. If I can't fly it, I'll shoot it instead. I don't like being shot by them though. That's not fun. It's that thing, isn't it? Oh god.
We have a lost Delta.
Am I just shooting blanks? Seriously. Why the fuck does this gun not work? Oh my god. Flying below zero some more, going to places I'm not supposed to go. I won't spoil anything, but I'm going to love this game. We went really, really far out, to like, the edge of the world, and there was nothing there. There was a bit where we went like 300 meters deep, and there was barely anything there. But we couldn't really find anything else. I'm going to just use a normal rifle. I'm actually just degrading myself to a fucking AK. Because for some reason, somebody's loading my RP with apparently blanks. Tunnel not available. Brilliant. We're on the last objective already. What? Fuck off. Just Google it, that shit's good. What, the traps? No, I've never actually looked at them. say you saw one of the wild. Yes, we saw one of the wild things. They're pretty. Apparently, I looked on the Blow Zero Discord. I was just flicking through to see what other people are saying. And somebody found that you can actually interact with those whales. You can press E on their horns and you can ride them. So, that's something to try. Oh, so sneaky American. Just running around like nobody's business.
Come on, pig! I'll get you!
Oh, fucking Jesus, fucking flipping Jesus, fucking blah. There we go, first kill. First of many, I hope. Don't spoil it, but yeah, I was finding a freaking alien whale. It was awesome. I didn't see the tooltip. Maybe I did. I just probably didn't see it. But yeah, I just read it afterwards. I was like, holy shit. It's a small pit with sharpened bamboo shoots. You can just fall in it. Oh, yeah, okay, I know what you mean. You make them deep and wonder if you're just getting paled. Yeah. I remember now. Because they look really small when you build them. Like that big. Yeah, I must have missed it.
Last, no surrender.
No surrender. No bomb. Do you smell burning? Oh god.
Hello.
Oh god, bad time to jump out there. Those are the shallow ones. Ah, right, okay. I remember the big ones, yeah. Shoot him. Shoot him. You're on the delay, you numpty.
Don't surrender.
Do 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 do. It's not great being on the other end, is it? Not just rocket propulsion. Let's go back into it. Yes, the Vietnamese have tunnels. So the Americans spawn on each other, and like all the southern forces, they spawn on each other, whereas the North Vietnamese, they can't spawn on each other, but they have tunnels. So they basically have like emplacements for spawning on. Which makes them a little bit sneaky, so they can hide other tunnels just like in bushes and stuff. So it's actually quite a good balance, really. It makes them different and it's kind of balanced. That's why the US is slightly better, maybe, for attacking. Because all the commander has to do, well, all the squad lead has to do is just keep pushing up and keep himself safe, and then the rest of the team can spawn on him. Ooh, new things. Torn pants, very short hair, a Mustang. Oh, it's a very nice helmet. Oops. Brilliant. What are we voting for? Oh god. Long tan. Okay. I can't. I'm voting for all of them. There you go. I went off the screen that was for voting. Whoops. Poontang. I hope it's another helicopter one. I was going to play on the helicopter only server, but there's like two people on it. I want to test my sick helicopter skills. This one doesn't have any. Snow is falling all around us. No, I want to be. Australian. Fine. I want to be Australian. I want to be Australian. Fine. Okay, there we go. Why am I squad leader? No. That was not going to last, was it? Oh, is he putting a squad tunnel on there? Oh, cheeky. Go on then, you madman. Do it, motherfucker. He's not doing it. Can you imagine if the clothes you could wear were locked to... or locked to your life level. Sorry, you can't wear to that t-shirt. It takes level 37. You're wearing it, what, in the real life? Yeah, that'd be good, wouldn't it? Like, if you're like level 1, you're just wearing like a grey t-shirt, grey trousers, grey shoes. Like, the more you level up in life, the more colourful you can get. That's a Black Mirror episode, if I ever saw one. I'd like to see that. Well, we all know real life is a video game. Level up. Buy things with currency. Yeah. Skills, some skill trees. I say cosmetic DLC is quite a big part of real life. Fuck. Dude, squad leader is just sitting there on his ass. Put the fucking tunnel in. What? Oh fuck, that's friendly. Oops. I just really want to shoot something. Deep root. See them. Where are they? I see one. Fucking finally. Jesus. After this match, we might have a look at the helicopter maps. See if there's a match going on. With a decent amount of people. Oh, fuck. Ah, right there. Team kill. No, that was fucking ridiculous. My team sucks. I won't push up. I'm trying to push up. But now we can push up. They got the push up now. Aussie. No. Sneaky.
We are taking Alpha.
Oh, there was a team kill. Wait, I thought the artillery barrage finished. Oh, okay.
We have taken Alpha.
Hey.
Thank you.
taking Bravo.
I think he's dead. What the fuck? Seriously? Surely that was a team. What the fuck? Sorz. No, fuck it. That's just ridiculous. You can clearly see I'm shooting forward. Fucking hell. Most of the time I forgive them, but it's like common sense. Like you just you're looking that way. You'd start shooting that way. I don't know what goes through people's brains sometimes. I don't know. It's very confusing. Move up. We've got smoke now. Let's move. Oh, watch out where he's going. He's just really admiring that rug. Really likes it. Has to roll around on them. Okay, don't want to go that way, it's good to see.
We are taking Charlie.
That was just over this ridge. Shit. There's one. No! Bastard.
We have a Dick and Charlie.
Took C though somehow. We just need B. So after this one, if there isn't any helicopter maps going, I'll just go back on the training. I just want to practice a bit more. Try and get control of that Cobra, because that Cobra is really difficult to turn. Like you do like a strafing run. I can do the strafing runs. That's all right. It's just like turning back round. Like you just basically go to a halt when you go back round. It's really difficult. So I need to try that out. Here we got a barrage strike coming in.
Bravo! taking Bravo.
Hang on, B, we just need C. Why did they lose C? Two of them. Fuck. Help us out, please. Right, fuck, I'll be squad leader. Whatever.
We are taking Charlie. We have lost Bravo. We have taken Charlie.
I'll do. As we all know, that's how we make tunnels. We just hack at the dirt until it just forms. Very scientific, that. Very scientific. Airstrike there. So the reason I don't like playing squad lead is because it's like responsibility. Because you have to like constantly mark out for the commander where to call in artillery. And it's a bit of a toss-up if he's actually fucking listening. Okay, maybe he is listening. They can't move up until there's at least a strike on that. And as soon as we put a strike on there, they attack C. So, no, that's great, though. That's really good.
We have a lost Charlie.
Good.
We have a taken Bravo.
Keep taking C. Where's the entire team? Okay.
We are taking Charlie.
Close. I'm not dead yet. I didn't get the kill. I'm just gonna put. I think there's someone there, and then let someone else deal with it.
Yeah, I think someone's there. Watch out.
Well, we've got both objectives. Let's keep moving up. Make a new trap. Make a new tunnel. And it was so, yeah, I could hear him. Try and put on the left flank. A bit more cover there.
You are squad leader.
I know, stop reminding me. You have responsibilities. Yes, I know.
We are taking Delta.
My binoculars.
We have taken Delta.
The thing is stuck. No, I wanna do binoculars. 5, 6. There we go. Oh, we took it. Never mind. I'm gonna do a responsibility. Won't be playing exactly. Exactly. I'll take on responsibility when I need to. And right now, I don't want to. You are my little minions. There you go. Spawn those straight to me. Cover. I'll try to. Keep going. Oh, he just ran right past me. Turn the route to my right. Is there a guy there? He's right there. Whoa, no, there's a guy there as well. So that's why dishwashing and laundry sims aren't a big thing. Saying that though, the sims, you have to do all that. But it's fun because you can make them wet themselves, so you know, swings around a bit. You are squad lead. You have responsibilities. Never forget that. We could actually just drain their tickets from here. This is actually a nice spot to attack. Right, let me see if there's any helicopter maps going on. If there isn't, I'm just going to spend probably like 10 or 15 minutes just on the helicopter training mode. Just want to get used to it.
Swapping side.
Swapping charge. It's a good map though. I like that one. Never really get very far in it, but yeah, it's quite good. Helicopter maps. Yeah, that's the one I always wanted, but yeah, there's nothing there, is there? Okie dokie. Right, boot camp. So I have some responsibilities, I'll check you all out later. No worries, Swan. Go and tend to your responsibilities. That's the word of the day. Responsibilities. No worries, man. Have a good one. Combat. I just want to get used to. Oh, sorry, the Cobra. I just want to get used to this just turning around. Because it's a real tricky bastard to move around. Strafing runs are fine, it's just turning around after the strafing run. That's where it gets a bit weird. Okay, so pretend this village is the enemy. Strike run, and then turn around real quick. Yeah, it starts blacking out. So it's how fast it slows down. It actually goes backwards if you go too fast. And it's that point in that turn, that's where you get shot. So I need to do it a bit smoother. Gotta do it smoother like this. Yes, it's slower, but there's like a bigger angle of turn, if that makes sense. You're covering more distance when you're turning, rather than going like this, just like straight away like that. That's what I'm used to doing, which is not very good, especially in the Cobra. The little bird we can get away with a little bit. Strafing run, and then turning around. There's a way you can do it. You can kind of lose a little bit of altitude and do the same sort of turn while going a bit faster, but again, you've got to have the height. Strafing run, yada yada. And then swing, turn, blackout. Crash into a family of six. Is the actual reality of me actually playing this in an actual war. Let's try the other way. Let's try going right. I always go left for some reason.
Strafing run. Yada 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 yada. So shallow. That's a bit better. Then you hold the height. There we go. That's much better. You gotta think ahead with these ones. Where you're gonna end up once you do your turn. Okay, so strafing run. Let's try left again. It's just inherently slower. That's the thing I just can't get used to. It's just slower than a little bird. Bigger helicopter. Okay. I kind of got the angle right. I know where the angle is. You can see that there's a little dial of where. Hang on, which dial is it? There is a dial somewhere. It's about. You see that one on the right? The black and white one. If you can get it about there, that angle is quite good for a turn. Like, that is awful for a turn, because you just go out of control. So you lose a lot of altitude and you crash. Like so. But if I keep it at that slight angle, then I think that will work much better. Whereas in the little bird, you can just do that straight away. That you can just go woo and just do circles. Without any repercussion whatsoever. So it's not too bad. Let's try and do the same thing in this and just see the difference. Takes off a lot faster. Is a lot faster. And then you can do these tighter turns. Let's try going a bit faster. Strafing run. Yeah, and then. So what I mean, you just have that maneuverability, and you don't lose that much altitude. You can just crack on again. Same maneuver. It was just in a fraction of the time compared to the Cobra. And I think it's. I think the little bird is just a bit more forgiving. You can just tilt it that way if you wanted. And there you go. There's a lot more flexibility. Of course, it's smaller. Less armoured, less armaments on it. That's a helicopter, though. I do like flying these. These are like my first choice in armour. I've got to fly those, because they're easy. But no, that's good. That's great. Ah. Does this game have co-op? Co-op? No, it just has multiplayer. You can do these co-op, like if you're fast enough, you can team up and do stuff like that. There's like squads in that, I believe. You'll know who's who in the game. So that's what you're wondering. So I mean, you can do those weird turns like that. That's fun. it feels like a mix between armor and battlefield, which is it's actually quite nice. It's just this thing where you can have the altitude set to what you want. I love that. In armor you don't have that, and in battlefield you don't have that. So it's nice to have that option where I can just leave it like that, have a slight gradual increase. What's on the agenda for the weekend? Don't know. I don't know what I'll be playing. I've got a bunch of stuff to play. Wash your glee, why your kings and queens, 4 to 10 decades for the gods they've made. A shy lad who killed the Kennedys. Well, after all, it was you and me. Rolling Stones, Sympathy for the Devil. Yeah, I know that one. You right, D? I'm about to finish. So, I was only prattling around with the helicopters. See if we can land on the base. Oh god, no. And that, children, is why you don't land on the base. Not enough room. Your fault. Get me some breakfast. Ooh. I'll be going to Dubai to have some dinner out with my friends. Cool. Very nice. I'll learn to land better. I am an ace pilot, and you all know this. This is ripped from the other map, isn't it? It's the same hill. I just realised. I saw a lot new playing Battlefleet Gothic Armada. That was a bad landing. Boom. New captain. Don't just blame the AI. It's never your fault. Oh god, I'm stuck here now. Oops. Oh god, I'm actually stuck here. Oh no. I think you can change your person on the fly. Didn't know that. Cool. Well, that's lovely. I was going to look at the new cosmetics that we got, and I can leave it there. We got torn pants. Why is it saying it's locked? I unlocked this. It's mine now. What the fuck is it? I'm level 35. Huh? What? Okay. I've got 2,503 points out of 2,145? Huh? Okay. Oh, no, there it is. Oh, it is right. Okay. Strange. Didn't want to work. Oh, no, it says 35 there, though. Oh, no, it doesn't work. That's torn pants. Okay. Not like I want torn pants anyway, but it'd be nice to unlock it. I want that. I want my cowboy hat. It's only unlocked a very short hair as well, which is 45, not 35. I think something's broken. I don't know. It's all a bit broken. I did level up. Oh well, whatever. Oh, those my arms. Did you hit my arms then? Fucking hell. They popped out. Right, I'm going to leave it there. Tonight, play. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe more of this. Maybe Terraria. We've got stuff in Terraria to do. I'll think of something. Back on later. Giveaway might be up. Maybe. For either Yakuza or The Division. If I remember. It's debatable if I'll remember. But we'll see. And viewer choice. Make sure you vote on viewer choice, as I always say, to decide what I'm playing on Sunday. Playing Gothic Armada? No. Soldier looks like a terrorist. And on that note, I'm going to end it there. Yes, so I'll be back on later with something. Maybe more of this when the server's a bit more populated. We can maybe try the helicopter maps. But we'll see. Yep, sorry, Portal. I'm ending now. So, haha. Right, yeah. You take offence to that. Of course you do. You take offence to everything. Right. Lovely. So, see you all later. Have a good one. I'll see you all in a bit. Bye!